Welcome to the session of exploratory data analysis and pre-processing. Exploratory data analysis, also known as EDA in short. So the meaning of the term is there in the term itself, right? That is, exploratory data analysis means exploring the data, correct? So guys, whenever we are working on a machine learning algorithm or any machine learning project, the first step that we do is to collect the data. Once we collect the data, the second thing is to understand the data, understand the hidden pattern, understand what are the questions, what are the answers that we can figure out from the data, correct? That is all about exploring the data, right? That also known as exploratory data analysis. So there are many tools, many libraries in Python that will help us doing the same, okay? Second is pre-processing or cleaning, correct? So guys, before we feed the data to a machine, there are few steps that need to be taken care of. For example, machine do not understand the missing values. If there is an outlier in your data, the prediction of the target variable will go wrong, right? If there is skewness, again the prediction might go wrong. Machine do not understand categorical data, as it understand only numbers. So you have to take care of the categorical data as well. So you can see under pre-processing, all the steps are given: handling missing values, handling outliers, handling skewness, handling categorical data. There's something known as feature engineering as well. What is feature engineering? You'll understand at the end of the session. Don't worry about it right now. So I hope the basic introduction on EDA and pre-processing is clear to you. In case if you didn't understand, please go back and watch it again. Next is the notebook and data reference. So for the notebook, you can just visit my GitHub page, GitHub repository, that is machine learning with Python. You'll get the notebook over here, right? So if you want to code along with me, you can code along with me as well. And whenever required, just pause the video and just continue, all right? There are a few prerequisites. Obviously, you need the knowledge of NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib and Seaborn, right? NumPy, Pandas are again for collecting data and manipulating the data and many others, right? Matplotlib and Seaborn for the data visualization, and descriptive statistics is something that you need throughout your journey of machine learning, all right? So in case if you don't have the knowledge on these subjects, please go back and watch the videos on NumPy and Pandas, as well as Matplotlib and Seaborn. We have also created a video on descriptive statistics. Please go back and watch in case you have no idea on these topics. Okay, so that was the introductory part. Now let's also do the basic imports. So guys, you need NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, right? So make sure you do all the imports. And then we import the warnings. This is just to ignore the warning, that's all. There's no meaning for, if you want, you can just ignore this, right? Just continue. Next is, the first step is to handling the missing values, right? To handle the missing values. So the missing values are most of the times in the form of a null value, right? NumPy library gives you an option to create a null value. And that's how you do it, np.nan, and we'll create a null value, okay? So guys, you can see that I have created few lists, then a dictionary from those lists, and finally that is converted into a data frame, right? So please pause the video, write down these lines of code, and create the data frame. I hope you have done this. Now, that's how your data frame looks like. All right, so it's a data frame which stores students' marks. The name of the student is given, the subjects are given, right? But there are a few places where we have the null values. Now remember, we have filled the null values intentionally, right? With the help of np.nan. Okay, so guys, whenever you have null values, there are various things that you can do. For an example, you can drop the null value, or you can replace the null value with some other value. So we're going to see both the steps, right? First of all, let's talk about dropping the null values. So to drop the null values, we just use a simple function called drop NA. Okay, we're going to use a function called drop NA. Let's use the data frame df dot drop NA. But hold on, guys, hold on. Even before you drop the null values, what about how do we check whether we have null values or not? So I guess this is something we have done earlier in the pandas lecture or somewhere, right? So still I would like to show that again. So how to detect the null values? First step is to type df dot is null, and this returns the entire data frame with true and false values. So wherever there is a null, you can see there are trues, right? But guys, imagine if you have a very huge data set, obviously it's going to create a problem. So instead of df.isNull, you can also call df.isNull.sum. So what this dot sum will do, column wise it will return how many null values are there in each columns. So name has 0 null values, math has 1 null value, science has 2 null values. Alright, so I hope this is clear, this is very simple. Now let's talk about dropping the null values. So let's see the data frame here. So again, math and science column has null value, math column has no null value. Now let me call the function df dot drop NA. Yes, so you can see guys that the rows which consist of null values are dropped. Okay, columns are there, only the rows which has null values are dropped. Similarly, if you want the opposite, that is instead of dropping the rows, if you want to drop the columns, then you just have to pass an argument access equal to 1. And that's how you drop the columns which have null values. Now guys, let me clear you one thing. These changes are not permanent. These are just temporary changes. If you want to drop them permanently, then you have to pass an argument called in place equal to true. But please don't do it. I just want to show you the argument, that's all. Why we are not doing it right now? Because I want to show you different ways of dropping the null values. So that is a way how you make the change permanent, but we'll do it later. So guys, I hope you're clear with this, dropping columns and dropping rows having null values. Now what if you want to drop them as per your choice? Yes, you can do that. So let's say there is a null value in row 2, right? So instead of calling drop NA function, you can call df.drop function, and there you can pass the row value 2. You can see the second row is dropped. Can we drop multiple rows together? Yes, we can. You just have to pass a list, let's say 2, 3. You can see both the rows are dropped together. And again guys, the same thing, this is not a permanent change, it's a temporary change. And you know what you have to do, you just have to pass an argument called in place equal to true, that's all. What if I want to drop the columns? Yes, you can do that. df.drop, then pass the column name which you want to drop. Let's say you want to drop math. Now when you call this function, it throws a tricky error. Alright. That is because it expects only the row values. But if you want to drop the columns, you just have to pass another argument, that is access equal to 1. So drop the columns. Alright, and same thing here again guys, you can, you know, pass multiple columns if you want. So let's say math, science. Yep, that's it. So that was all about dropping null values or dropping as per your choice, right? So let me just give a quick recap. So df.isNull.sum was all about detecting the null values. Drop NA function to drop the null values, drop the rows which consist of null values. Drop NA function with access equal to 1 argument to drop the columns which have null values. Then simply calling just drop function to drop as per your choice. So you can pass the rows which you want to drop. And similarly you can pass the columns, but again you just have to pass an argument called access equal to 1. That's all. Okay guys, so that was all about dropping the null values. But remember that dropping null values may not be the best thing, or may not be the best solution, because if you go and just drop the null values, you might be left with few data, right? Only a few bits of data, that's all. So better let's, you know, think of a different solution that is filling the null values. So let me give a heading over here. That is to fill null values. Okay. So change it to markdown. So we're gonna fill the null values. All right, cool. So how do we fill it? We just call a function called fill na. Let me show you the data frame again. You can see that the entire data frame is exactly same. Even after calling the drop na and drop function multiple times, we have the entire data frame exactly same because those were just temporary changes. Now let's say wherever we have a null value, you want to fill them. So yes, we can do it. We can call df.fill na and just fill it with any value. Let's say you want to fill it with 0. Just fill it with 0. So you can see there is no null value anymore, right? And again, guys, remember my point. This is just a temporary change, okay? Now, guys, is it a good choice to just fill it with a random number? Obviously not, because you're just changing the pattern of your distribution, correct? But remember the statistics lecture. Central tendency. Central tendency will never change the distribution pattern, right? And that is why instead of filling it with any random number, always fill the null values with the central tendency. So guys, in this scenario, we have math and science. These are numeric data and looks like they are just simple, continuous values. So we can just fill the null values with the mean, correct? So let's do that. Let's find the mean value for math and science and then fill them. So df select the math column dot mean. So that is a mean score for math. Df science dot mean. And okay, I guess the spelling mistake. Yes. So that is the mean score for science. All right, the science column. So we cannot access this because there's no reference. So let's create some reference. So let's say math underscore mean equal to this and science underscore mean equal to this. All right. Now let's fill the null values with the math mean and science mean, right? So guys, make sure you don't call df.fillNA anymore because that will fill the null values for the entire data frame. You want to choose the math column first and then you want to fill with math mean. Guys, this is a change which I want permanent. So I'll pass in place equal to. Similarly, df science column dot fill na will pass science mean, then we'll put in place equal to. Let's run the code. So guys, now the changes are permanent and let's see the data frame now. Yes, now my data frame is completely free of missing values. So again, let's quickly do a recap on filling the values. So to fill the values, you can use a function called fill na, right? But it's always a better option to fill rather than filling with a random value, fill them with the central tendency. In this scenarios, we have math and science column, both the columns have continuous value. So we are filling the values, the null values with their particular mean, all right? And then we are making this change permanent. That's why we are passing the argument in place true. Okay. All right. So that was all about handling the missing values. Stay tuned for the next topic.